Hello viewers, do you have trouble starting your car in the morning when its engine is stone cold? Or you may have noticed it doesn't have the punch it used to have when you put your foot down. Well, given how complex modern cars are, this can be caused by many things, with the intake air temperature sensor being one of them. Now, you might think something as trivial as that couldn't possibly be responsible for such significant problems, but you'd be wrong. So let's see what's what. First of all, what happens when the intake air temperature sensor is bad? The common symptoms here range from an illuminated check engine light on the dashboard to hard cold starts and engine issues, often accompanied by a drop in performance and increased fuel consumption. But let me explain each of these a bit more elaborately. As you may imagine, the car's ECU closely monitors all the sensors, which includes the intake air temperature sensor, and if there's something off with the signals they are sending, it'll trigger a check engine light on the dashboard. But because this warning doesn't tell much on its own, you'll need to plug in the scan tool and check the codes. One of the most critical moments for the car is when you turn the key and crank the engine, especially when it's cold. In these first few seconds, the amount of fuel injected into the intake needs to be just right, and that's hardly going to happen if the intake air temperature sensor isn't giving correct readings. As a result, the air-fuel mixture will be all wrong, and you'll have trouble starting the car. The next thing a bad intake temperature sensor is likely to cause is poor acceleration. Or in other words, your car won't have the same punch as it used to have when you put your foot down. Again, incorrect data could make the ECU think the air going into the engine is colder or warmer than it actually is, leading to miscalculated air-fuel mixture and consequent drop in acceleration. Another condition when the engine is very vulnerable is while idling, when even the slightest defect can cause it to be rough, with the needle on the rev counter continuously or sporadically jumping up and down. Obviously, this can happen because of many things, like a dirty throttle body or fouled plugs, but the intake air temperature sensor shouldn't be overlooked here either. Then we have misfires, which occur when the combustion inside the engine cylinder fails to happen. You'll recognize this as hiccups or interruptions on accelerations, or you may notice the engine's juddering and shaking instead of running smoothly. Also, in some cars, the check engine will be flashing if there is a misfire. Again, this can be caused by worn spark plugs or failing ignition coils, but it can also happen as a result of incorrect air-fuel mixture. Almost all newer cars have an EGR, whose job is to return a portion of exhaust gases back into the engine to get burnt once more. The flow through this system is controlled by an EGR valve, which in some models adjusts its operation based on the intake air temperature. Obviously, if the intake air temperature sensor is bad, the EGR's function might be affected as well, causing all sorts of issues, all of which you can learn more about in one of our previous videos dedicated to this subject. Lastly, one thing that almost always goes hand in hand with engine issues is a drop in gas mileage. In normal conditions, when everything's as it should, the car's ECU constantly adjusts the air-fuel mixture to ensure maximum fuel efficiency. One of the essential information for this is the intake air temperature, so if this sensor gives incorrect signals, the engine might use too much gas, or it might not get enough of it, resulting in a lean running condition, which can be damaging in the long run. So if you notice a different fuel consumption than normal, it can be caused by a failed intake air temperature sensor. The intake air temperature sensor has only one purpose: to monitor the temperature of the air that goes inside the engine. This data is crucial for the car's ECU for many functions and calculations, such as calculating the air density for effective ignition timing and fuel efficiency. The fact is, cold air is denser and hence has more molecules of oxygen needed for combustion than warm air, and the amount of injected gasoline needs to be adjusted accordingly. The nature of the intake air temperature sensor's job dictates its location, and you'll find it somewhere on the pipes between the air filter and the intake manifold, or on the intake manifold itself. On some cars, though, it might be integrated within the MAF sensor. Now, you may think finding the EAT sensor is a straightforward job, but that's not always the case, as it may be hidden by other engine components. If having trouble locating it in your own car, it's best to refer to the service manual for that particular make and model. Assuming you've successfully located the intake air temperature sensor, it might be a good idea to do some tests before replacing it, just to make sure it's to blame. The diagnostic procedure for this is relatively easy, and you can do it yourself, assuming you have some basic knowledge and the tools. Have a repair manual for your car ready as well. For a start, plug in the OBD2 scanner to your car and then turn on the engine. Now go to the live data menu and find the intake air temperature. Typically, the readings should be 10 degrees more or less than the vehicle's ambient temperature, depending on the outside temperature and the engine's temperature. If the readings are not realistic, there could be a problem with your intake air temperature sensor or the wirings to it. This, for instance, would be if it shows temperatures over 300 degrees or has unrealistically low values. To be absolutely on the safe side, you'll want to check the sensor's resistance using multimeter. If the ohm values you're getting don't match those provided in the repair manual for your car, there is no doubt the sensor is bad. But if the sensor and its resistance seem okay, visually check and measure the sensor's wiring and the engine's control unit. Lastly, what I'm sure you're anxiously waiting to hear is how much the new intake air temperature sensor will set you back, assuming it needs to be replaced. On average, these sensors can be found anywhere between $20 and $100, depending on the brand. And changing them is, in most cases, a dead simple job, so even if you have the mechanic to do it, it shouldn't take more than half an hour. Things are a bit different, though, if the intake air temperature sensor is integrated into the MAF, like here. In fact, this is a pretty common solution, and your car might be using this configuration, meaning the whole MAF sensor needs to be replaced when there is an issue with the intake air temperature. In that case, the part cost can increase rapidly, with some MAF sensors costing up to $400. Also, I'd point out that if you have a newer car, you want to look for a technical service bulletin for that particular model. In some cases, such as with a Chevrolet or GMC vehicles, you'll find a suitable bulletin with a solution for the issue. So that would be all about the intake air temperature sensor, what it does, how to tell if it's bad, and how much it costs to replace it. I hope this video was helpful, and if so, don't forget to hit that like button and share it with your friends. But if you're still having troubles with your engine, a whole lot of other things could be causing the issue. So to continue troubleshooting, check out other videos here or visit our site mechanicbase.com for detailed automotive repair guides. Bye!